Well, some are already calling tonight a Republican surge. With such a shift in Kentucky, how does this impact the political climate in Kentucky? WIMT's Neil Middleton is joined now by former RNC Chairman Mike Duncan and Executive Assistant to Governor Beshear, Coleman Eldridge.
Well, thank you, gentlemen, for joining us again tonight. What a historic night for Kentucky politics. Mike, Republicans, I think, had a better showing than maybe anyone predicted. Was this a surprise for you tonight?
It was a surprise in the margin, Neil. I think there were a lot of winners and losers tonight, but let me start off by congratulating everyone who ran. It's very difficult to run for public office. It's hard on your family. It's very difficult for you. And I want to congratulate everyone who was in the arena. Yes, it was a surprise tonight. I think there were some clear winners and losers. Obviously, Governor-elect Bevin, he's got 35 days to put together a government. He's got to put together a budget within 100 days, and Kentucky's got a lot of problems that he's going to need help with. So my congratulations, and I look forward to people helping him in this task that he has. I think another clear winner tonight was not on the ballot, and that's Rand Paul, because no one came out of the Democrat ticket with momentum that will enable them to mount a serious campaign. We see how Kentucky is dividing itself now. We see the red counties all over the state, east and west, and the old way of taking the urban areas against the rural areas is not going to work. And it's the Obama presence in the state, not Barack Obama himself, but the presence of his policies in the state, how it's held us back economically, both on health care and also with government regulation, particularly in the coal fields. So I think Rand Paul was a clear winner tonight.
Coleman, what are your thoughts as you watch these numbers come in tonight?
Well, Neil, I think it is surprising to everyone. Again, the margins of victory across the board. But I think Kentucky's going to have to do some soul searching. I hear the chairman talking about Kentucky being in such bad shape, but Steve Beshear has a heck of a legacy in terms of job creation, in terms of providing health care for over 500,000 people. All of that is, I think, now up in the air with the governor-elect Bevin. And so, you know, it could have been just people looking at anybody with a D next to their name and seeing, absent of anything else, the face of Barack Obama and voting that way. But I am emboldened by the fact that this president won't be president forever. And I think the Republicans are actually going to have to show they can govern these next 4 years or find a new boogeyman.
Coleman, you heard Mr. Duncan talk about next year's Senate race, and Rand Paul is going to be running for the U.S. Senate. What do the results tonight? I mean, we've heard Adam Edelin's name mentioned. We've heard Allison Lundergan Grimes. Edelin lost. Grimes in a very close race. How is that going to impact that race next year?
Well, I'm not sure yet. I think, you know, tonight is tonight, and tomorrow I think the party begins to look at itself and to begin to do some analysis, listen to the voters of Kentucky, and then we will come to that point where we have a nominee, and I believe we might have a primary or we may not. I actually don't believe that Rand Paul came out on top. He's running a fledgling presidential campaign. I don't believe people view him in the same change agent way that they did when he was elected years ago. And so I think we will run a strong candidate. We will run a strong campaign and begin to turn the tide back to electing good Democrats and good public servants, I will say, across this state.
Coleman, you've been mentioned as one of those possible candidates to face Rand Paul. Do you want to elaborate on that tonight? Are you going to run?
You ask my wife, Neil. You know, I've been very, very thankful and very humbled by people all across the state asking me to step up to the plate. And you know, tonight is tonight, Neil, and I'll tell you, we'll revisit that conversation tomorrow.
So you're not ruling it out?
I've never ruled much of anything out.
Mike, let's talk about this race and how it might impact statewide races, specifically for the state house, where Republicans have been making some gains. Do you see this having an impact on that in the coming years?
Definitely. I see that there's going to be momentum moving toward the Republican control of the state house to go along with the state Senate to give this governor something that we've never had before, the ability to have the executive branch and the legislative branch working together to change things. While Coleman believes that the governor's done a great job and he's been part of that administration, you've got to look at the financial condition of Kentucky. Look at the teachers' retirement, the state employees' retirement. We've got looming financial problems out there that could cause us to be downgraded with our bond rating, and it's going to take a unified effort to do that. And that's why I think that you're going to see a lot of people looking and saying, okay, let's give them a chance. The Democrats have had control out of the last 50 years, 42 of those years. Let's give the Republicans a chance to see what they can do with this economy. And I think you saw that with a lot of voters tonight. I'm really interested to see the final results and find out who voted, because I think the momentum that was shown by Bevin toward the end had a lot to do with first-time voters and irregular voters, voters that may only vote once every three or four elections. So I'm anxious to see the final returns.
Let me ask each of you one last question here. Mike, I'll start with you. You were an advisor to President Bush. You were also an advisor to the last Republican Governor Ernie Fletcher. What advice would you give Matt Bevin as he begins to govern Kentucky?
Put together a great team, and I think he's already started that. Mack Brown has been working as the chairman of his transition team. We've had people from Eastern Kentucky on that transition team. You have 35 days to come up with your cabinet. You've got about 100 days to get a budget out there. So getting financial advice, putting forward your best ideas at the beginning of the administration, these are all important things for him. Who he surrounds himself with is extremely important. The most powerful time that you have as governor is that first day, and then you start delegating things. So people make a difference. They make a difference in integrity. They make a difference in policy. Choose good people around you would be my advice.
And Coleman, I'll put the same question to you. You are in Governor Beshear's administration, and as a Democrat with experience in an administration, what advice would you give?
I would say very simply, and Steve Beshear has been, I think, the epitome of this, you cannot govern as an ideologue. Coming into office, Steve Beshear said he didn't care if it was a Republican idea or a Democratic idea, if it was a good idea and it was going to move Kentucky forward, he was willing to work with anyone. And what you have seen this governor do is work with a Democratic-controlled House and a Republican-controlled Senate to really do some big things on behalf of the people of Kentucky, especially Kentucky's children, improving Kentucky's health. And so my best piece of advice to Governor-elect Bevin is, we've heard a lot of his ideological bent over the course of this campaign, but set ideology aside. You cannot govern how you campaign, and once you govern, you are governing for an entire state. You're governing for the people who voted for you and for the people who did not. And to try to bring people together, understanding he's not always going to get his way, but there are good people on both sides of the aisle who want what's best for the people of Kentucky.
Okay, gentlemen, I appreciate Mike Duncan, Coleman Elridge. Thank you again for joining us tonight. Always a pleasure.
Thank you, Neil. Goodbye,
Thank you so
Coleman.
Thank Good you. To see you, Chairman.
Thank you. Steve, back to you.